said, "The first of the people words that they should be called to account for on the day of judgment is the prayer, Our Lord, holy, holy and exalted, will say to his angels while knowing better than they, look at the prayer of my servant. Did he perform it in full, or fall short of it? If it is in order, then he will have prospered and succeeded. If it is wanting, then he will have failed and lost. While if anything is missing from it, he will say, look to see if my servant has any supererogatory worship, and if he has, Allah will say, complete my service obligatory prayers for him from his supererogatory works, and he will be dealt with likewise in his other works. Hence, we should increase our supererogatory worship to conclude the obligatory ones. If they fall short of the punishment of he who misses the congregational prayer, then he is able to do. Allah the Almighty says, the day that the shin shall be laid bare, and they shall be summoned to prostrate, but they shall not be able. Their eyes will be cast down, ignominy will cover them, seeing that they had been summoned aforetime to burn adoration while they were whole and had refused. Although they were whole in this world, they did not answer the call to prayer. On the other hand, led by Allah, this ayah is only revealed concerning those who miss the congregational prayer. Oh, what is the fear torture awaiting for those who are able to perform the prayer in congregation, but they do not? The Prophet said, I have considered having a man lead people at prayer and going myself to those who hang back from attending the prayer in congregation to burn their houses down upon them. Behold, this threat cannot be issued unless there is something obligatory left. It was related that once a blind man came to the Prophet, peace be upon him, and said, O Messenger of Allah, I have nobody to lead me to the mosque. Then he asked for a permission to pray at home. Thereby the Prophet permitted him. But before leaving, the Prophet called him and said, Do you hear the call to prayer? He said, Yes, the Prophet said. Then you have to respond to it. Came to the Prophet and said, My Messenger of Allah, in Medina there are numerous number of reptiles and beasts, whereas I am a blind man and live far away from the mosque. Further, I have an inconvenient guard. Shall I have a dispensation to prayer time? Then the Prophet asked, Do you hear the words of the call to prayer? He said, Yes, the Prophet said. Then you have to respond to it. I have no dispensation to you. Behold, that is a blind man and faces many hurts upon his way to the mosque and has no guide. Yet the Prophet does not permit him to pray at home. How about the sightful people who have no excuse? Therefore, is asked about someone who fasts the day and prays the night, but does not attend the Friday or congregational prayer. He replied, If he dies doing that, he will enter the hellfire. It is better for one's ears to be filled with molten lead than to hear the call to prayer without answering it. Related that the Prophet said, Whoever heard the call to prayer and did not answer, not because of an excuse. Someone asked, What kind of excuse is that, Messenger? He said, Fear or sickness. He will not have his prayer accepted, the prayer which he performed at home. But the Prophet said, There are three people whom Allah cursed. Whoever leads a group of people in prayer who dislike him A woman whose husband spends the night angry with her, and whoever heard the call to prayer, but who does not answer. May Allah be pleased with him, said, a prayer of a neighbour of a mosque is only accepted in the mosque. Someone asked, who is a neighbour of a mosque? He said, whoever hears the call to prayer. He noted that the Prophet said, a person who likes to meet Allah tomorrow on the Day of Judgment as a true Muslim, he should then take care of those prayers where and then he is summoned for them. This is necessary as Allah has laid down some practices and rules for us to follow which have reached us through our Prophet, and these prayers are among them. If you offer prayers at your houses, as this good-for-nothing person is doing, you will be guilty of neglecting the way of your Prophet, and you go astray. I have seen the purple in condition when only known hypocrites used to be out of the lines of congregation. Some of us used to be brought to the mosque with the help of two men on account of their weakness or illness until they could stand in line. After the disease in his leg, he used to go out for prayer, leaning on two men. They advised him, O Father of Muhammad, Allah has permitted you to pray at home as you have a legal excuse. He said, okay, but I hear the call to pray. Whoever could answer, even if he creeps or crawls, it is better to do so. One day I missed a prayer in congregation, but no one led me except Abu Ishaq. However, if one of my children died, there would be 10,000 people who offer me condolence. This is because a trial in religion is easier than a one at the sight of Allah. Someone of early Muslims said, a congregation prayer is missed because of sins. Was in his garden when committing back, he found that the people had performed the Asr prayer. Thereby, he said, we will surely return to Allah. I missed the Asr prayer in congregation. May you witness that I gave my garden in charity to the needy so as to expiate what Umar had done. It is recommended to pay more attention to Isha and Fajr. It is recommended to pay more in attention to Isha and Fajr. The Prophet said, the hypocrites find dawn, Fajr, and not Isha prayers in congregation as very oppressive. If they could know the virtues of these two prayers, they would certainly join them, even if they had to go crawling. So Fajr and Isha are... Fajr and Isha. Remember these two. When we sing a man in the congregation the prayer of Isha and Fajr, we might think that he was a hypocrite. I have never missed Isha prayer in congregation. One night I had a grief which occupied me from performing the Isha prayer in congregation. Thereby I sought for another mosque allower, a lover. Al-Bashar to realize a prayer, but of no avail, the mosques were closed. Then I went home and decided to apply what is stated in the hadith, recompense for prayer offered along with the congregation is 27 times more than the prayer offered in home. Therefore, I performed Isha prayer 27 times afterwards. I slept, I dreamt that I was riding my horse, racing some other people who were also riding their horses, but I could not catch them. Then one turned to me and said, do not get your horse tolled, you would never catch us. I asked him why. He said, we performed the Isha prayer in congregation, but you did alone. Then I got up, so sad, we seek Allah's help and guidance, for he is the most generous and most righteous. bounties. Okay, so we've got 4 bounties.